Hello students, today I am going to discuss recurrence relation for the moments of binomial distribution. In my previous videos, I have discussed what is binomial distribution, its moments, MGF and CGF. So, I will be putting the link of it, of some of my videos, so that you can have a look for it. Okay. So here recurrence relation for the moments of binomial distribution. We know that the rth row moment about mean is, in short, whenever you get recurrence relation for moments of binomial distribution, you need to put this formula. Mu r dash is equal to x minus summation of x minus mean per in whole bracket power r into p of x. Students, what is mean of binomial distribution? The mean of binomial distribution is np. And the variance of binomial distribution is, it is NPQ, right? So, the mean of binomial distribution is NP. That's why we are writing NP over here in place of mean. And P of X, formula for binomial distribution is N choose X, P power X, Q power N minus X. Remember? And it is mu R dash, right? So, here, if we write this Q, you can write this Q as, because P plus Q is equal to 1, we can write Q is equal to 1 minus P. That's why in place of Q, we are writing 1 minus P here. Then, we will differentiate it with respect to P. We will differentiate this whole line with respect to P. Just remember this point, students. In further discussion, I am going to discuss about it. Very important. See here, x minus np power r, n choose x, p power x, q power n minus x. You know this formula, n choose x, p power x, q power n minus 1 is binomial distribution formula. The thing which is added is x minus np power r, yeah, right? Now, here, if you are putting r in the power place, here you are putting mu r dash. If you have r plus 1 in power place, you will put r plus 1. If you have r minus 1 in power place, you will put r minus 1. So, just for the understanding purpose, I am saying that we will write this formula in this way only. So, now, here if we differentiate this with respect to p, it will be here d by dp is equal to, we will keep this constant outside, n choose x, summation of d by dp of this whole thing, which is x minus np power r and p power x and 1 minus p power n minus x. See here, students, if we differentiate this, by default I have written in, it is there in the video, u and v. It is, this is u and this is v. So udv plus vdu, right? If you are differentiating this one, this will be u. It will be same. Then differential of dv is, here you have again this r two, no, this one and this one. That's why what you are doing, you are writing u, then differential of v is again uv. So u and v form you are doing. So u and v. So here what you will write, p power x into n choose x, differential of x power n is nx power n minus 1, no? That's why n minus x into 1 minus p power n minus x minus 1. Because differential of minus p is minus 1, we are writing minus 1 over here. Then u dv plus, you are writing plus here. Then v, the same thing you will write here. The differential of p power x is x power p minus x into p power x minus 1, right? You are writing here. Then close the bracket. Again, you will write this whole thing. This is v, right? V you are writing here. And differential of x minus np power r. You will write r into x minus np power r minus 1. Again, differential of np is what? Minus n. You are writing here. Again, you got this one in this. Now what you are doing, you are multiplying this whole and writing here. the first n minus n choose x summation of the this value and the multiple of this. Again n choose x summation of this value and you are multiplying with this. You will get this value and this value. Then n choose x you will write, summation you will write, and the whole value, this value here you are writing. Now understand students, I have put here in blue underline this x n choose x in and summation x minus np power r in and p of x and x minus 1 minus p power n minus x. Here it is the same, again here it is the same. You are only left with n minus x and minus 1 and 1 minus p power minus 1, that is nothing but 1 by 1 minus p, right? So minus you are writing here, this minus, again n minus x you are writing here by 1 minus p, because it is in inverse you will write in the denominator. Then you will put plus, again this thing is same which is written here, you are left with x and p inverse, right? X by p you are writing here, because it is plus you are writing plus. Again here you will write this minus here, then the same thing, x n choose x, summation of p power x, 1 minus p power n minus x, this r and n you will write this side. Again you have this thing, right? Just I am underlining with black line because just to make you understand. See here student, n choose x, p power x, 1 minus p power n minus x. It is in this form, no? Just now I asked you to remember this. It is in this form, right? You are just having in place of r, it is r plus 1. So here if it is r minus 1, here also you have to put r minus 1. In short, you can put it in the form, in this form, new r minus 1 dash. That's why here you have r minus 1, no? That's why in the next discussion, what we are doing, you are writing in this whole underline, black underline one, we are writing it as this one, right? This again, mu r minus 1, n r, and after the simplification, you will get, just cross multiply this, you will be getting this value. See here this value, then after cancellation of this you will be left with n my x minus np by pq. Again students, x minus np, this pq you are writing outside, you are having n choose x, the summation, and x minus np, you are having n x minus np over here also, so bases are same, you can add powers, right? That's why you are writing power r plus 1. Here it is plus 1, no? So r plus 1, p power x, n minus 1 minus p power n minus x. Then again the same thing, minus mu r minus 1 n r, right? Mu r minus 1 dash. Then students, you can put 1 by pq same. See students, again it is in this form, n choose x, p power x, q power n minus x. You are having this r minus 1 here. That's why what you are doing, r plus 1. Mu r plus 1 dash you are writing, this minus you will be writing here. Then this n r you will be writing here. And mu r plus 1 dash. Again, because it is mu, you have differentiated this one, it is d by dp of mu r dash, right? So just put this to this side, you will be having mu r plus 1 to the left. Just put this to this side, you will be having mu d by dp of mu r dash, and this is negative this side. If it comes to left side, it will be positive n r mu r plus 1 dash. Again, you just cross multiply this PQ, you will be left with this answer. This is the answer of this recurrence relation for moments. Again, we are going to solve recurrence relation for the probability. So, by definition of probability mass function, you have P of x is equal to, you know the formula of binomial distribution, right? N choose x, p power x and q power n minus x. Again, if you write in place of x, if you are writing x plus 1, it will be n choose p of x plus 1, n choose, this is x plus 1 students, by mistake, it is written x, p power x plus 1, q power n minus, in place of x plus 1, you are just removing this bracket, that's why x minus 1 it is becoming. Here, if you put plus in brackets, if you put n x plus 1, just remove the bracket, it will be x minus 1, right? So again, the recurrence relation of probability is, you need to solve it this one. There you have done mu r dash, here you have to do p power p of x plus 1 by p of x. Then you got here, if you are solving, what is the formula of n choose x? It is n factorial by n minus x factorial into x factorial, right? If you are writing n choose x plus 1, here it is plus 1, no? X plus 1, no? So, n factorial by n minus x minus 1 factorial into x plus 1 factorial. Again, p power x, and you can write p power 1 also, no? Again, q power n minus x, and you can write q power minus 1, right? Then you are writing this one also, n choose x, p power x, q power n minus x. Denominator also, here it is n factorial by n minus x factorial, right? Now, what you can do, you can cancel this n factorial and n factorial. Then what else you can do, you can cancel this x factorial, p power x and p power x, then n, q power n minus x and q power n minus x. You are left with p and by q, right? P by q. Then you are having, here see students, n minus x factorial you are having and x factorial. If you extend 5 factorial, it will be 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, right? If I am extending n minus x factorial, it will be n minus x minus 1 factorial. So then it will be going, go on, right? N minus x minus 2 factorial, n minus. So what I am doing, I am just stopping here, n minus x minus 1 factorial. So I can cancel this above, numerator and the denominator. Again, see students, x plus 1, if I extend this, it will be x, then x minus 1, so on. So because I want to cancel this x factorial, what I will do, x plus 1, then x factorial, I'll stop here. See here, x plus 1 and x factorial, I am stopping here. I will be cancelling the this x factorial with this denominator x factorial, just to cancel this one. And whatever I can cancel, I am doing the calculation. So now what is the thing I am left with? I am left with here p by q and x plus 1. There is no factorial because I have cancelled x factorial and x factorial. Only x plus 1 you are having. Here you are having n minus x. 1 by n minus x you are having. So because you cancelled this n factorial, no, there is nothing here. That's why it is 1 by n minus x. So here you are having p by q into x plus 1 and power n minus x by 1, right? So the answer, now you will get the answer as p by q, and you will write n minus x by x plus 1. Here you will write again, just you will get the answer as p of x plus 1 is equal to q by p into n minus x by x plus 1 into, even you are cross multiplying more, into p of x. That's it. This is the answer, students. Thank you for listening to my lecture. Bye.